Hi everybody, in this video, we're going to learn about SUMO networks and how to create a SUMO network by hand and also using NETGENERATE. We're also going to learn how to create a simulation in SUMO. So first, what is a SUMO network? In SUMO, a SUMO network file defines the traffic-related part of a map. The SUMO network file defines the roads and intersections that simulated vehicles run along or across. A SUMO network is basically a directed graph, and like a directed graph, the SUMO network consists of nodes or vertices and edges. The nodes and vertices represent intersections that are called junctions in SUMO, and the edges represent the roads or streets, and they are unidirectional. The SUMO network contains the following information. Every street, which is our edges, are a collection of lanes, and that includes the position, shape, and speed limit on every lane. There are traffic light logistics that are referenced within the junctions. The junctions include the right-of-way regulations within them and connections between those lanes and junctions. These can be enhanced by user input formats and set processing options so that they can include districts and roundabout descriptions. Now that we know what a SUMO network is, let's create a SUMO network. This is the network that we are going to create. It's a very simple Manhattan grid. This can be done by hand or by using NETGENERATE. So first, let's learn how to create a SUMO network by hand. In order to create a network by hand, we must first create a node file. The node file describes the junctions in SUMO. Node files normally have the extension .node.xml. So let's make a node file. And I'm going to make this in a folder called SUMO Tutorials. So I'm going to make a new file, and this will be sumotest.node.xml. That's its extension. This is an XML file. And let's edit this file. So we need to define the nodes for our network. So in this case, we have a collection of nodes. So in XML, we start our attribute with the nodes attribute, saying that there is a collection of nodes, and let's close that collection of nodes. Now we need to define each node in our network. In this case, I have our network that we are going to be creating down here, and I have our nodes labeled. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, all the way to 18. So when you're defining a node, you declare the node, and then you set the ID. The ID can be a string. In this case, I'm going to have our ID be this number. So ID equals 1. Now this is representing the string 1, so you could call it intersection 1 if you wanted to. The next parameter that we have is our x. This is going to be a float. So in the case for 1, it is at 0, 0. So it's at 0x and 0y. So x is 0.0 and y is 0.0. This is all that is required in SUMO. There are other optional parameters that you can add. For example, you can have a type, and we can set the type of our intersection to different values. In this case, we can set it to priority. The type priority in SUMO means that vehicles that are on a low priority edge have to wait until a vehicle on a higher priority edge has passed in the junction. There's other types that you can have, such as traffic light, right before left, unregulated, and several more. There are other types as well. There's TL type, which denotes the traffic light algorithm, and then there are radiuses, shapes, right-of-ways. So there's lots of attributes that you can add to your node. Right now, we are just doing the type. So we have 18 nodes. So let's add our second node. So our second node is going to have the ID 2. And at its position, it's down here. So it's our entire length of our SUMO map is 2 kilometers or 2,000 meters. So our XY is done in meters. So our x is still 0, but our y is now at negative 1,000. So this is where node 2 is. Let's add node 3. So node 3, our x is still at 0, and our y is at negative 2,000. Let's add the remainder of our nodes. If you look here, this 4, our entire length of our map is 2.5 kilometers or 2,500. In between each one is going to be 500 meters. So there, our next X point will be at 500, and 4, 5, 6 will have the same Y. So if we copy this, we can make this 4, 5, 6. Our X is at 500 meters. All right, let's finish up the remainder of our nodes. So here's the remainder of our nodes written out. We have 7, 8, 9 at 1,000, same for our Ys, and we're going all the way down. So this defines our nodes. Now we need to define the edges. So we need to create an edge file. An edge file describes our roads, and it has the extension edgedg.xml. So we'll make a new file. We'll call this sumo test.edg.xml. And let's open up this edge file. Now we need to define our edges. So we will have a collection of edges. So this will be edges. And within our edges collection, we define our edges. So our edges are going to be what connects from one node to another node. So our edges have an ID, and they also refer to the nodes as before. So if we said that this edge right here that connects 1 to 2 is E1, we would create an edge, and let's call it the ID E1, and it will say it connects from node 1. So our node ID from earlier, we named it 1. So from 1 to 2. Then you can set the priorities for the edges. This works because our junctions are paying attention to what edges are ending up at the location. You can also set up the number of lanes for that street. So in this case, we are going to make our priority 2. And we can declare the number of lanes. So we can say that the num lanes is 2. So there's 2 lanes on this edge. You can also set the speed. So we can say here, our speed is 14.0. This speed is in meters per second. So this is 14 meters per second, which is about 31 miles per hour. We can then close our edge. So this has declared edge 1. So what we would want to do is declare every edge that is connecting from a node, from one node to another. So edge 2 would be connecting from 2 to 3. And let's keep the priority and the number of lanes and speed the same. So we can update this to be edge 2, and this goes from 2 to 3. So you can finish up the remainder of the file. What I like to do personally is start with the edges going vertically and then going horizontally. Now granted, this is a Manhattan grid, so it's a little bit simpler. This would be the completed edge file after you make all edges first vertically, which will go all the way up to 12, and then the horizontal edges that are connecting as well. There's several other optional attributes that are available for an edge as well. You can denote the shape, the length, the what type of vehicles are allowed and what type of vehicles are not allowed. So those would be access permissions. And you can also set the width. And then you can even go more detailed into the edge for the lanes and set which lanes allow specific ones. So if you had a lane that was bus only, you could set that lane to be allowing only buses. So now that we have created our node and edge file, we can now run the sumo command net convert, which will turn the sumo test.node XML file and the edge file into a network file. So we're going to open a command line here, and we can write net convert dash dash. Let's let it know our node files. So this would be node files equals sumo tests.node.xml, and then we let it know our edge file, edge dash files equals sumo tests.edge.xml, and then we let it know what the resulting output file is. So you could do dash o or dash dash output files and declare it as sumo tests.net.xml. So now we've successfully created our sumo network. If we open up our sumo test.net.xml, you can see that this is generated. It lets us know what its inputs were and then what the output value file was. And this is the resulting sumo network. Now, we can also create this sumo network using NETGENERATE. So if we go back to our command line, we can use the command NETGENERATE, and we can specify different types of maps. So NETGENERATE works for different types of abstract networks. You can create a grid network, which is what we're going to be doing, a spider network, and random networks. So we're creating a grid network. So we would say NETGENERATE, then we give the type that we're generating. This will be dash dash grid. And then we let it know the number of junctions in the X direction, and then the number of junctions in the Y direction. So if we look at our image here, we have 6 junctions in the X direction and 3 junctions in the Y direction. So we would say dash dash grid dot X dash number equals 6, and dash dash grid dot Y dash number equals 3. Then we set up what our lengths would be in the X and Y direction. So in our X direction, our length was 500. And in our Y direction, our length is 1,000. So we can do dash dash grid dot X dash length equals 500. And dash dash grid dot Y dash length equals 1,000. And then we would specify our output file. In this case, dash O, and it will be sumo test, we'll say 2.net.xml. So this has now generated sumo test 2.net.xml. This is the result of using NETGENERATE. Now, you can add a bunch of different options when you're doing NETGENERATE. For instance, you can set up turn lanes. You can also change the default speed. The default speed is 13.89 meters per second. So you can update the default speed. You can update the default priority. The default priority is -1, which means that there really isn't a priority. And you can also update default types, and you can also add default disallows. So you can play with a lot of options within NETGENERATE. We're just doing a simple example to make that Manhattan grid. So both sumotest.net.xml and sumotest2 are roughly equivalent. So now we have made a network. If we open our sumo GUI and we open our sumo test network, we can see our network. So that is our network. That's our Manhattan grid. That is what we just generated, and it is equivalent to the image that I showed earlier. So now we've made the network, but we need to set up the simulation. So in order to create a sumo simulation, we need to create at a minimum a roots file. Sumo offers a Python tool called randomtrips.python, and this generates random trips for a given network. And that's why we set up this network first. It will make the results, output it in a specific trips.xml file. So let's use our random trips. So we're gonna call randomtrips.py, and then we're gonna specify our network. So dash N to specify the network. In this case, it's gonna be sumo test.net.xml. Then we can specify the end time for our simulation. So in this case, we're going to say that our end time ends in 600 seconds. The default is 3,600. So our n is 600. And then we'd specify our out file. So dash out, and we'll say this is gonna be sumo test.trips.xml. Now this creates a random set of trips. So we open up our trips file. You can see we have a trip and it tells which edge it's going to the other edge and so on and so forth all the way up to the depart of 599 because it starts at zero. So now we need to convert these trips into routes. So we can use duo router. We specify our network still. So dash n, and this will be sumo test.net.xml. Then we specify our routes file. So we're going to say dash dash root files to specify our trips. So this will be sumo test.trips.xml. And then we specify the output file. So dash o, and it will be sumo test.roo.xml. Now, not every single randomly generated trip is going to be valid. And if you choose not to ignore errors, you will see every single trip that is failing. So we can add a ignore errors. And we are going to now generate our root file. Only difference is I messed up the extension here, but that's okay. We can just generate our root file now without the extension being messed up. So now you will have your sumo test root file created. It also creates an alternative root file as well. So if you open up and you look at this code, you can see here is our sumo test.roo. The input was our sumo test.net and also our trips. Our output was our root XML, and we also have an alternative output here. And here are our vehicles and the point that they're departing from and the edges that they are traveling on. So we can use now the root file and our network file to set up a configuration for our sumo simulation. So we have one last file to create. So we make a new, call this sumo test dot sumo dot cfg, because this is going to be our configuration file. So if we open up this, we will add our valid XML for a configuration file. We actually kind of have a template given to us in all of our generated files. So we denote that this is an XML file, we specify our configuration, and then we specify our inputs. In this case, our input for our sumo config file is the net file, and that value is gonna be sumo test.net.xml, and then our roots file, which will be sumo test.roo.xml. And then we also have our time, which will denote the beginning and the ending value. So if we save this and open our sumo simulation in the sumo GUI, it will load up our network as before, and this will be very quick. So let me zoom in a little. But you can also run your simulation. So if you see quickly, there are vehicles going through and the simulation time stopped. So congratulations, you've just learned how to create a network and a simulation in sumo. You can now use these sumo configurations, your network and your root file, and add them to your veins simulation and test other maps that you have generated on veins. If you liked what you saw, please subscribe to my channel so you can get other tutorials on Omnet++ and sumo and any other tutorials that I make as well.